So mechanism of sulfonation of benzene. So benzene when treated with sulfuric acid, it gives benzene sulfonic acid. That's the basic reaction, but mechanism is very very important. So mechanism we can make in three steps. First will be generation of the electrophile, second will be attack of electrophile, and third will be removal of H plus. So first step will be the generation of electrophile. So here what happens is the sulfuric acid, the two molecules of sulfuric acid, it will give the H3O plus hydronium ion plus the sulfur trioxide SO3 and the HSO4 minus. So it dissociates into hydronium ion, sulfur trioxide and the HSO4 minus. Here SO3 will be the electrophile. So this will be the electrophile. So how it behaves like electrophile means like S double bond O, R double bond O and the double bond O. So oxygen being more electronegative, this will have the negative sign and sulfur will have the positive sign. So in such a way it behaves like an electrophile. So the electrophile generated in this mechanism will be SO3. So next step will be the attack of electrophile on the benzene ring. I told you in case of benzene ring what happens is one of the pi bonds, the two electrons move towards this carbon, making this carbon negative and this carbon positive. So I can write like this, the double bond will disappear because the two electrons are moving towards this carbon, making this negative and this as positive. So this carbon will become negative and this will become positive. And this is stable because of the sigma complex that we already discussed in the last two videos. That is sigma phi and plus, that is sigma phi and the plus. Now the electrophile, we know that the electrophile will be sulfur trioxide, which is S double bond O and the double bond O. Because of the electronegativity, oxygen will be negative, this will be positive. So this plus will all can go and attack the minus here. Now all the way it will go and attack the minus. So the product will be added like this. So you can write the S double bond O, that you can write as SO3. And here still we have the positive charge. And we know that in case of carbon, each place we got a carbon and a hydrogen. So next step what happens is removal of H plus, the third step. It will be the third step will be removal of H plus. So now what happens when this is treated with HSO4 minus? This HSO4 minus will pull this hydrogen as H plus, leaving the two electrons here. That can be used for making the double bond once again. So now what happens is, so the structure I will write like this. Now we got the SO3 and this hydrogen will come out as H plus and react with HSO4 to form the H2SO4. And the last step will be, because we know that the sulfur, in case of sulfur, it is between sulfur and oxygen, oxygen is more electronegative, so it will be having the negative charge. All the structure I will write once again. To make you understand, it is sulfur, maybe the sulfur double bond O and the double bond O. Because of electronegativity, this is minus and this is plus. So when it take an H3O plus, what happens? Because it's having negative sign, the proton will move here. So that's what you get. The product will be like this. Already we got SO3 and the H, so we'll get the SO3H. After losing the H plus, this becomes water molecule. So this will complete the mechanism of sulfonation.